The 470 is a two-person dinghy measuring 4.7 metres in length, with one helm steering and a crew on the trapeze. This lightweight, planing dinghy has been part of the Olympic lineup since its debut at the 1976 Games in Montreal. Equipment is controlled, but can be modified to a degree in order to better match the boat and the sailors. Men and women compete in two different fleets for two different medals, though in the same type of boat. With seven world titles to his name, Matt Belcher is the most successful 470 sailor of all time. Belcher, with fellow Australian Will Ryan, are looking to improve on the silver medal from Rio 2016 and are many people's favourites for Tokyo gold. Spain's Jordi Chamar and Nico Rodriguez have set a new standard in downwind dynamic movements in the 470 fleet, with the rest of the world working hard to match the Spanish team's work rate and mastery of working the waves. This could be a critical skill in the big rolling swell expected to arrive on at least a few days of the Games. This year's world champions Anton Dahlberg and Fredrik Bergström have a strong possibility of becoming Sweden's first ever Olympic champions in the 470. Others to watch are New Zealand's Paul Snow Hansen and Dan Wilcox, who won the European Championships earlier this season. Wilcox's father, Hamish, won three 470 world titles back in the 1980s, but never got the chance to represent his country at the Olympics, so Dan is looking to win that missing medal for his family. There's another family connection with the 470 class in the French crew. Thierry Pepinet won 470 gold at the 1988 Games in Korea, and now his nephew, Kevin Pepinet, aims to maintain the family tradition alongside his crew, Jeremy Mille. As 2018 world champions and runners-up at this year's European Championships, the French certainly have the pedigree to make the podium. 19 teams will fight it out in the 470 fleet. Their first race is scheduled for Wednesday, the 28th of July.